Well, guys, I don't know if you can see me or not, but this is day two of the Greenfish Nation Texas Trail Championship. Me and Thomas are getting out here on the water and going to do a little fishing ourselves. Had a great day yesterday. Big shout out to Thomas. He actually won the Jackson Kayak Tournament Championship yesterday. How many inches did you have, Thomas?
90 and a quarter inches.
So congratulations to him on that. And we're gonna get out here and do a little fun fishing today and see who's gonna bring home the bacon here on the GFN Texas Trail. We are heading to the north end of the bayou. About a 2 mile run. We fished Star Ditch yesterday. We had a great day. I think I ended up with about 25 with a total of about 90 inches. So we're gonna go see if we can't top that today. Good luck, you guys. Start out with the old flopper flopper. Thomas showed me a couple tricks with this thing yesterday. I'm not really going to talk about them because it's kind of his secret, but. I'm not a big whopper popper fisherman, but Thomas is. Well, there was one. He liked it. I tried to ramp camp last night. ended ended up having to go to town and get a hotel because the mosquitoes are just, they're just fierce out here. I mean, we are in a swamp. Just so you'll know, there's about three choices in Jefferson for hotels. So if you're planning on coming to Caddo to fish, you probably need to make arrangements here in Uncertain to have lodging. I will tell you that when you fish Caddo Lake, three things about Caddo Lake that you need to realize. Number one, you're fishing a lake that is not man-made, it's natural, made by God. So it's a pretty amazing place. There's nothing man-made about this place. It is completely natural. It is in the middle of nowhere. Jefferson's about 20 minutes away. Number two, it is definitely a bayou culture here. The people are great. They're honest folks. They work hard for their money. The every little restaurant that's down here, they feed you like your family. They're not terrible expensive, but the food's really good. We ate at a place called Hooker's last night. Had a fish and shrimp. Golly, there's a blow up right there. I missed. I had a fish and shrimp basket. It said it had two pieces of shrimp and two pieces of fish and fries and hush puppies, a couple hush puppies. It came out, it had four pieces of shrimp, five pieces of fish, and four hush puppies and a basket full of French fries. I couldn't even eat it all. And it was like $9. The third thing you need to realize is you are in a swamp. There's alligators. There's alligator mosquitoes. And, it's beautiful. You're fishing history. This is a place where hundreds of years ago, the Caddo Indians hollowed out cypress trees, made canoes, P-Rows and kayaks, and they fished this lake for food. They trapped beavers here. I'm sure they ate a few alligators and a few wild hogs along the way. This is just a place that you have to experience. There's no other place like it that I've ever been to. As you scroll through this video, you'll see it's just unbelievable. It's so beautiful. Words can't even do it justice. Every clump of grass, every tree, this looks like it would hold a bass. It doesn't, but it looks like it should. You'll see all kind of wildlife here. Bald eagles, like I said, alligators, some of the biggest water moccasins I've ever seen in my life are here. Thank God they're not real plentiful. There's chain pickerel. There's bass. In the bayou out there, you can catch some sand bass. There's catfish. And what we call grinnell here in Texas. I think a lot of people call them bowfin, but I was raised up with it being a grinnell. All right, guys, we've had a couple misses on this whopper plopper. I think I'm gonna move two. What I had a lot of success on yesterday, and that is this Berkeley Nessie. I done really good on this yesterday. I caught a good number of fish on it. Fishing the ditches. I probably missed as many as I caught. We're gonna try to change that today. I did have a lot of followers on this thing, which I liked. That was good. That I haven't fished a Nessie a whole lot, but I am a fan of it. It just looks too good not to be successful. It looks like a shad. You can swim it. I just kind of reel and pump it. I have had them hit it right here at the boat. I've had them hit it as soon as it hits the water. I've just slow reeled it. I've twitched it. Thank you. drank it two or three times and paused. I missed one right there. We go. Finally talked him into it. I am really not wanting to get a hook in my hand this morning. He followed it three times. Well, we won't photograph that one. Because he decided to go on a trip. He was 13 and a half. So I was doing a kind of a, just working it with my reel, just darting and pausing it. And he committed. I imagine you could do the same thing with a fluke. But I like this little Nessie. This is a 5, I've got a 7 and a 9 inch. But this 5 kind of matches the hatch. About the size they're eating here. It might be just a hair bigger. Not a whole lot. Maybe a half inch or so. fish. That's number two for the day. On the old Nessie. Different techniques. I threw a speed worm some. Through this Nessie. Threw a frog a little bit. And also threw a wacky rig a little bit. Caught a couple on the wacky rig just around the trees. Number three. Looks like we're having a dink fest today. I don't care, I'm just fishing, just having fun. This might be a little better fish. A little better. Oh yeah. Yeah, that'll add to my Tyler reels. Total for sure. Nice little 17-inch Caddo bass. 17-incher. Thanks for the tug, buddy. Not a giant, but oh, got off. Gave him too much slack. There's about another 16, 17 incher. He hit that thing as soon as it hit the water. There's another good one. Oh, that was a good fish. That was a good fish. When you seen him, he was pulling me around. There must be some bigs down in there. That was a lot better fish than that 17-inch one. Another feisty one. And these guys are built like little tanks. Decent fish. Another solid Caddo bass. Don't need you to flop off, okay? Now you can go. Mm-hmm. That one was 17 and a half. Like they're laying right down in the bottom of that ditch. Guys, if I was fishing a regular tournament, I'd definitely be using a net. But I'm just fishing for fun, and I'm fishing a little pre-tournament. It's put on by Tyler Reels Fishing. So I ain't really... I ain't really stressing about all that. I was fishing for money. I definitely would be using the net on all of these fish. And photographing and measuring all of these fish. But like I said, I'm just out here having a good time. Soaking in some of this beautiful lake. Thinking like a fish. I'm gonna have to break my sunglasses out because the old sun's getting kind of bright on my eyes. So I'm gonna bust them out. Put them regular peepers up. There we go. How's it going this morning?
Doing better now. I actually caught a fish on the board.
Yeah? I heard you catch one just now.
Yeah, you hit it right when it hit the water.
What are you throwing?
Jackhammer.
Jackhammer.
I was throwing a buzz bait, but I weren't really committing to it.
Yeah?
Never been on this side.
Yeah, this is kind of where I've only been here like three times, so. Oh, down that way? Isn't it?
I guess it's down that way. I go like in the middle of nowhere on the off-beach trail and put in.
Yeah.
But it's always overgrown this time of year, so I didn't go over there and mess with it.
I caught 15 so far this morning.
Schooling fish or inside fish?
I caught a 17 and a 17 and a half.
Yeah.
And then I missed, I got one right up to the boat. I'm gonna guess he was probably 20. But I'm catching them on this little Nessie right here.
Yeah.
Man, they've been tearing that thing up.
Huh.
I just been throwing it out there and just.
A 6-inch glide bait or a 5-inch?
It's like a little 5-inch soft-sided glide bait.
That's cool looking.
Man, I'm telling you, that thing right there is...
Got one treble hook on it or two?
Just got one, but it kind of floats, slow floats.
Oh, yeah.
And you can literally just, you can burn it to the boat. I mean, it don't roll on its side or nothing.
Nice.
But it's made by Berkeley, but uh-huh. Man, I'm telling you, that right there is...
I've seen the big ones I have.
Yeah, I've got a 5, a 7, and a 9. And I've been throwing this 5. I caught 25 on it yesterday.
Dang.
I've caught about 15 this morning.
And just, over in there?
Yeah, back up that M channel. Mm-hmm. Just working my way down that channel.
How's it look over there, like, trash-wise? Because it was a bunch of crap floating in there yesterday.
It's about like this. I mean, it's got open spots, and then it's got a bunch of junk in it, you know, different places, but there's some open spots too.
I'm gonna go check that out actually.
Well, I'm gonna head over here to Ames and see if I can't burn this thing through some of this hydrilla.
Are you talking about here to the right or left?
Just that group of trees straight out.
Okay, I went too far back. I was gonna start at Ames and I didn't know what the difference was, and I went too far back that way, but I'll probably head out there later.
So yeah, if you go here and then down that way, it's pretty good usually.
Yeah, well, down that way is where I kept missing them on the boat there, but they weren't
committing.
They might have been kicking me.
Oh yeah.
All right, well, don't sore lip on my fish.
Oh, I won't. Little skinny long ones. I don't care who you are, that's fine. It don't matter who you are, how long you've been fishing. It don't get any better than that right there. We're gonna do like the old Caddo Indians. We're just gonna paddle around out here. And fish. Kind of in stealth mode. off. We'll be back in business. All right, we'll just paddle back. It doesn't matter. One way or another, we'll get there.
All right, guys, I want to thank y'all for fishing this year with me. And I couldn't have done this year without Thomas. He's been a great help to me. This is my first ever time to do any kind of kayak tournament. It's been bass fishing my whole life. Got in the kayak, actually met Thomas out at Lake Welch, and just it's been going on from there. So I do appreciate each and every one of you. We will be having our national tournament here the 26th and 27th. I'll have details coming up in the next week about that. Enough about all that. This weekend, I think everybody had a pretty good weekend. I know I caught more fish here this weekend than I've ever caught. This is my third time here. But I know you guys all caught some good fish. Feel like everybody had a good time, but we're gonna give out the top three places since this is our Texas Trail Championship. What's the 162 and a quarter.
Thank you.
Trying to get rid of some of this trash out of my hand. Thomas, get in here. Couldn't do it without you. There you go.
Thank you.
Appreciate you.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you.
Also, I got a hat for you.
Joe. Oh, nice.
You like your hat guy. Thank most kayak people.
You can pull that hair somewhere.
Put that right in there.
Mine gets cut off.
Second place is going to be Chance Van Winkle.
171 and 3/4.
And this year's state champion with
180 and 3/4.
Okay. With a day today, you had 98 and a half.
That's the most I've ever had in a single.
And you also caught your personal best on Tourney X today of 23 and 3/4. So first place this year goes to Brian Thomas. Appreciate you. We had some pretty good hammers on the water. Let me get my little scrap napkin out here. I got all the statistics wrote on. So we had a close race between Brian and Chance.
He came out of nowhere.
And Brian, he kind of threw a ringer in the hat today with two big fish, a 23 and a 23 3/4. You ended up with 916 3/4 points this year. So congratulations on Angler of the Year, the first ever Greenfish Nation Angler of the Year. Anyway, I do appreciate you guys all believing in us, and I want to thank you. I can't say that enough.